Hi guys, Jay here from Breach18.com, and today we're going to be looking at Sheep and Thief. Now, this is a re-implementation of a Japanese game, and wow, the gameplay is the same great gameplay, but with an amazing production value and overall quality to the components. So, in Sheep and Thief, the object is to get sheep and points. The most points at the end of the game wins. So the core mechanics in the game are card drafting and tile laying, and the cards double as sort of tiles. So you have a board and you will be drafting these cards which have paths on them, and you'll be putting these cards down and creating these paths along the way to connect to cities which are worth points at the end of the game. You also have rivers which are worth 2 points per each river card they go through, but they're not as easy to place. If you get a sheep, you get a sheep from the general supply and put it on your card. Excellent. However, if you get a fox on the card, you get to move the fox either up, down, left or right, depending on your preference. The thing is though, is whatever direction you move that fox, everybody else has to move it in the exact same direction. So if you move it in a way that it would cause another player to move theirs onto a card which contains sheep, you get those sheep and put them in your pen. Another thing I want to mention is that you get barns, which mean that your sheep are essentially safe. So it doesn't matter if a fox comes along, it's not getting any sheep. And the other thing are dogs or hounds. So for every picture of a dog on a card that you lay, it means you get to move either one or a herd of sheep that many spaces to safety. So if you think, oh, the fox is coming, I best move them out the way. If you lay a card with a hound on it or a dog, you can then move it. So that's good, right? So this game is so quick and so easy to learn, yet it's got some real strategic depth to it. And it's just a fun game. Gotta get some shape. I've got a flipping shape. Sheep and Thief is just an awesome game, not just to play with friends, but for family as well. So I played with my family, so that's an 8-year-old, an 11-year-old, and, well, I won't tell you how old the other one was, but the point is it's so much fun. And the artwork's amazing. They've done such a cool job. I mean, some of these cards, you've got Doctor Who with the TARDIS on there, and you're drafting these cards, and you're laying them down, trying to make these roads connect, and placing sheep on when you get the sheep. So place this card down here, that's a legitimate one, otherwise it's not very good, but I can do it. So I'd put 2 sheep on that because it's got 2 sheep there. So you're making these roads all the way, and the constant thinking of what card you're going to get, because remember, you're drafting, so you might like something initially in that hand of cards, but by the time it gets back round to you, the card that you want might actually not be there anymore, which can really, really mess you up. So you constantly have to think on your toes and think about ways that you're going to be scoring those points. So whether you go for the roads to the towns to get the points, so you've got one what's worth 5 down here, 5 up here, or 10 down here. Or do you just go full out sheep and get as many sheep as you possibly can? Or do you go down the route of just stealing sheep with the wolf? You know, you just go around with the fox and just generally steal everyone's sheep and put it in your pen. Or do you go rivers? Rivers are very, very worth it in terms of points, but they are a lot harder to place, because like here with the roads, that's legal. It doesn't matter if that road continues. That's fine to do that, but rivers are very different. They have to join or go off the edge of the board. So there's a lot to think about in this game that is essentially so quick and easy to play, but so much fun. There is nothing more enjoyable than stealing your 8-year-old sheep and seeing him scream over little sheeples. Maybe that makes me a bad parent, but I think that's pretty fun.